In this problem on a single dimensional array, we are going to do something which is going to help you understand arrays, that is a single dimension, also pointers and how pointers are used effectively in writing functions. So what this particular program is going to do is, suppose I have a series of numbers in an array. Let's say we call that as array A. I have these numbers 1, 2, 1, 2. I am expected to print each number only once or only the unique numbers once. So my output is going to be 1 and 2. And I'm going to assume that my output is going to be in array number B. So first what I'm going to do here is, I have defined max 50 so that the size of my array A is going to have a maximum of 50 numbers. Array B is going to contain all the unique numbers from array A. So A is your input array, B is your array containing the unique numbers. N is used to indicate how many numbers the user is actually going to enter. Although the capacity is 50, the user may say, I'm just interested to enter 10 numbers. So I'm going to ask the user, enter the number of elements into an array. The user is going to say 5, 10 or whatever it is, that is going to be stored in this particular N. Then I'm writing my own function called as readArray with A and N. A is represented by X and N is represented by N. Since arrays are passed by address, whatever values I enter in readArray are going to be reflected back in the main function. So when I say enter elements into the array, from the 0th element to say 5, I am going to store all the 5 numbers using this particular for loop. A few things are required to be explained here. See, when I have written array A, in the prototype I have declared int A of like this. This is as good as saying star A. Both mean the same. An array is nothing but it's a pointer or an address of a particular location. This indicates it's an array, this indicates it's a pointer to a particular location. So thereby both mean the same. So some programmers prefer to use this. I prefer to use a star A sometimes and A this time depending upon the user. So everywhere where I'm passing the array, you can see I have used the complete name of the array as it is, indicating that the array is being passed by address, but this is actually going to be a pointer. This is a pointer, this fellow is also a pointer, and here this parameter of course happens to be a pointer. Now I'm going to write a function called as find unique, where I'm sending this particular array A, I'm sending the array B, which is going to store all the unique numbers. So what is going to happen here is, array A is going to get copied into, let me hide this also, array A is going to get copied into X, or X is going to represent array A, Y is going to represent array B, and N is the number of elements the user has entered. So first thing what I'm going to do is, I'm going to define a variable called as counter with the initial value 0. Then I'm going to use a for loop. Okay, what I'm going to do in this for loop is, I'll explain it as I complete the typing. So in this for loop, what I'm going to do is, for every element in X, I am going to check, okay, whether that number X of I already exists in array B or not. If it exists in array B, then I should not be inserting that number in array B. So what I'm doing is, I'm passing the 0th element to this function called search. Alright. So here in search, what I'm doing is, let me say I have another variable called as, okay, I don't need the int variable here. I can say for int I is equal to 0. I less than star CTR. This will be clear in a short while now. I plus plus. And then here what I am going to do here is, I am going to compare if number is equal to Y of I, indicating that whether the number is already stored in this array B or the name given here is Y. If it is already stored, I am going to do a return of minus 1. If it is not stored, then I need to store that particular number. So I am going to say y of star CTR is assigned the number. That means the first number is copied into the 0th location of the array B, or called by the name Y here. Then I need to see that next time to store the next number, I need to increase the position of counter by 1. Now the reason why using this variable counter is, counter is used to keep track of how many unique numbers are going to be stored in array B. So every time I store a unique number in array B, I am going to increase counter by 1. When I say B, I mean Y and B are the same, X and A are the same. So here I am going to come And I'm going to say return 0, indicating that a new number has been inserted. Now what we shall do is, we need to, after inserting all the unique numbers, we need to print this unique array. Okay, I'm going to print this unique array. So here what I'm going to do is, I'm going to pass the array y and I'm going to pass the counter so that it prints all the unique elements on the screen. So what I'll do is, I'll first take this particular program, I'll try to execute it for you, then I'll go ahead and explain so that you understand the concepts. Okay, so far lucky, it's running at the first shot. So let's enter only 4 numbers so that you really understand it well. Let me enter the number as 1, 2, okay, and 1, 2. So the output should just print 1 and 2, it should not print 1, 2, 1, 2 twice. So let's see if that's happening. Okay, perfect. So it's, if you see here, it's giving you the correct output. I have entered 4 numbers. These are the numbers 1, 2, 1, 2. So this 1, 2, 1, 2 is stored in array A. Then this unique numbers 1, 2 is stored in array B or Y. Array A and X are the same. Array B and Y are the same. Alright. Now let me go ahead and explain step by step. So what I am doing here is, here I have asked the user to enter how many numbers. Here you can say I have set 4 numbers. In read array, I am going to read those 4 numbers. So starting from I equal to 0 till 0 less than or equal to 4, I am putting those 4 numbers into array X, or which is also array A. So array A now contains 4 numbers. Now in order to find the unique number, I need to pass the array A as well as the array B, which is going to contain a list of all the unique numbers. And this is going to be sent to a function called as findUnique. Now once I send to a function called as findUnique, in findUnique what I am doing here is, I am sending the array A, the array B and the total number of elements n entered by the user. So in findUnique what I am doing is, x represents the value of, or represents array A, y represents array B and n represents the total number of numbers in array A. So this counter variable is going to keep track of how many unique elements exist in array B. So starting from the 0th location, I is 0, x of 0, 1, okay, this value 1 here is going to be sent to this particular search function. In this search function, I is 0, counter initially is also 0, so 0 less than 0 is false. So counter is 0, star CTR is 0, at the 0th location number is going to be inserted, number happens to be 1. Alright, then what I am going to do is, I am increasing the counter by 1 so that next time the new number gets inserted in array Y at the first position, so counter becomes 1. I go back here, okay, I is now 1, first element is 2, 2 is sent here, I is 0, 0 is less than 1 is false, but when I search here, 2 is not there in this array Y. So in the first location, 2 will be inserted and counter will be increased by 1. So counter from 1 will become 2. Now I go back here. Now I see this number 1. 1 is sent here. I is 0. 0 is less than 2. So I come here. So when I compare here, I am going to find that 1 is already existing in array B. So I am not going to do anything. I am going to do a return 1. Same will happen with 2. Once that happens, I am going to call a function called printUnique, where I am going to send the array y as well as the counter. Once I send array y, it is simply going to print all the unique elements of the array. So I hope this makes it clear how I have printed unique elements of an array. This program is going to be used to make a slight modification to print the frequency count of every element in an array. That is your next program I'm going to show you. So please make an effort to take a look at the description section of this video, where you will get this code. Take the code, run through the code, analyze it and play around with it till you understand the logic.